God aften. Sidste lørdag og søndag havde Danmark besøg af den tidligere Beatle Paul McCartney, som sammen med sin gruppe Wings gav to udsolgte koncerter i København. Vi fik lov til at lave en snak med ham efter koncerten lørdag aften, og vi havde på forhånd fået at vide, at vi under ingen omstændigheder måtte snakke om The Beatles. Derfor er det meget sjovt at notere sig, at samtalen, eller hvad man nu skal kalde den, lynhurtigt udviklede sig i en retning, som ledte tanken hen på de gamle, glorværdige Beatles-dage, da alle pressekonferencer var kaos. Det vil sige, at det hele gik i alle andre retninger, end den, man forsøgte at styre den hen i. Paul McCartney havde også stillet som betingelse, at for at lave interviewet, så ville han have hele sin gruppe med. Så derfor startede vi med i, skal vi sige, demokratiets hellige navn, at bede hvert enkelt medlem af gruppen om at præsentere sig selv og sige, hvem de var. Og det fik det her forløb.
My name is Joey. Everybody goes.
Well, the real Joey.
Okay, Joe. Please introduce yourself into the camera.
Hello, everyone. I'm Joe English, and I'm from Rochester, New York, in the good old U.S. of A.
I'm Joe English. I'm from Glasgow, Scotland.
My name is Joe English. And I was born in Liverpool.
My name is Joe English, and I was born in New York City.
And just to be different, my name is Danny Lane. And I was born in Brom.
Birmingham.
I've been a bum ever since.
Okay, which one of you goes under the cover name of Jim McCulloch then?
The cover name, that's me.
Vogue
to see.
When do you use that cover name?
Why?
When?
Or when?
For our records. When do you use it?
On record and this and that.
The laws are.
But otherwise, I'm Joe English.
Which one is Paul McCartney then?
That's me sometimes. Will the real Paul McCartney.
There he is.
That's me.
The real Linda Eastman, sorry, Linda
Eastman. No, Linda McCartney. She got
Linda
married.
McCartney, I'm sorry.
She got married 7 about years 7 years ago.
I took the big step.
Sorry,
got married. How do you know my name's Linda Eastman? Know me back in New York?
Because that's a film you're using.
Oh, could it? Well, I'm Linda McCartney, so look out.
I always thought it was cold in Copenhagen, blimey.
Linda Zero.
It's actually.
Your name's Edmund?
My name is Edmund.
Hello, Edmund.
Hello, Copenhagen.
Tivoli. How did you like the show tonight?
It was all right. It was all right. Did you like it?
Very much so, yes.
Oh, well, we liked it.
Yeah.
It was a good one.
I should like to know a little bit about the films that you've been making in connection with your single releases, because you've been working very much with PR films, so to speak. And the films are very different, all of them. Why? Or how do you work with those films?
We don't know. It's the same as now. You see, we just turn up and they turn the camera on and we do silly things and that's it.
Yeah, I mean.
Like now.
Do you like the show, you mean, better than the films?
No, I was just interested in knowing how you made the films, because I mean, taking it from high up through, which was made in a studio, and through Helen Wheels and Mary Had a Little Lamb, and you know, up to the last one to make the Mars and Venus thing.
Yeah,
They're very different in concept.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's art, man. It's art.
We had a good director.
Yes, but you have been talking about going into films, at least according to Chris Welch. I don't know if it's true.
Oh yeah.
Was it?
Melody maker.
Well, we haven't started yet. Those are something else.
I've been told that you went to visit the Danish Queen today.
Yeah. Well,
what happened?
Well, you see, we were touring around and we went to see the mermaid first.
Yes.
And then we went to see the Queen and
we
saw a car go in. So we rang the bell, you know, and we heard she's only 34, so we thought
she might like to have us
probably
in for
still
tea
alive.
With
might like, you know, might
cup
like
of
a cup of tea, something, yeah.
What
did they say? Bit of Danish bacon, you know. So we rang on the door, and there was a man there. He said, no. And we said, but, you know, we'd like to see the Queen. He said, no. And he was closing the door. He said, well, tell her the McCartney's called.
And he said,
no. And closed the door, just like that.
Just like
that.
So we're hoping to see her tomorrow.
Let him in.
I'm going to try tomorrow.
Yeah, I hope she's coming tomorrow.
To the show, you mean?
Yeah. She's bring her earplugs, she'll be all right.
Rock and roll, a bit of rock and roll for the Queen.
You've got a lot, and from what you've got, I'd say you're doing well, dear. Dressed like a dream, and if things are what they seem, you're looking swell, dear.
I just read some of the stuff about your new album that's going to be released in 14 days or something like that.
Wings at the Speed of Sound. Yeah. Or...
Oh, don't do it. I can't remember it. Wild, I had it written down. I can't remember it now. I haven't got the paper.
Well, I could lend it to you, but I haven't got it either.
Hey, Arno, what's
Speed of Sound in Danish?
Med lydens hastighed.
That's it.
Med lydens hastighed.
You've got it.
Thank you.
That's well very good. Religious history here.
Yeah. That's but, that's the first album where all of you sing.
Yeah. True.
We do. We all have a number on the album. We all sing.
Do
sing
I do
song.
Do you like the fact that everybody sings?
Give me the moonlight.
Can I have a sip of your beer?
Give me
the girl. Plug the bleeding thing in.
Well, I like the fact that you did it in the show tonight. So.
We like
but
beer.
How did the idea start with everybody singing?
Everybody can sing.
Yeah.
Yes, but as it says in the press release, I'm quoting now, that you normally don't ask a drummer to sing. Unquote, Paul McCartney.
That's right. Yeah.
When the drummer plays backwards.
Actually, on the track that Joe sings, Paul plays the drums.
Yeah.
So what we'll do, if we do Joe's number, Paul will get in the drums and Joe will come forward and sing like a nightingale.
Versatility. With vibrato.
One of the numbers were written with you together with the Colin Allen.
That's right.
X Focus now.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
X Stone the Crows before that.
Yeah, I know. But you've written several songs together with Colin, haven't you?
Sure.
Is he the only one you work together with when you work?
No,
songs?
We did Medicine Jar, or Venus and Mars. We co-wrote that together. We co-wrote this one, Why No Junker.
But he said, is he the only one you work with?
Oh, absolutely.
It's love.
What about you, Danny? Because you've written songs by yourself, and you've written songs together with Paul as well.
Yeah. One of the songs on the album is Paul's Jump Singing, The Note You Never Wrote. One of them I wrote.
I can't
wrote
remember what that
lovely.
One's called.
Time to hide.
Yeah.
See?
You know, I mean, it's a bit of everybody, really, when you get down to it.
And Danny wrote Time to Hide.
And apart from that,
and the new album.
Watch it. It's good Danish beer, you're
supposed to. Oh, are you kidding? You got to be kidding, surely. Special brew is good
special
Danish
brew.
Beer, but this ain't.
Oh.
Do you mind?
Australia, we were in a kitchen. And in the kitchen, you know, it had salt, vinegar, sago, macaroni. You know how people have that all around the kitchen?
Aussie, man.
And I just took the words off the wall. They were all there on the wall. And then there was a plaque
so
that said the second
It's not as creative verse. As you think, is it?
So I'm not really that good. You see, I just take it off the wall.
Well, that's the way we could Victor Borge does his stuff, I'm told. But that's the one that you sing, Linda.
The Borg.
Yes.
May I ask, what's Borg the song?
Handle.
What's the song about?
It's, there's a line in it that says, no matter where I serve my guests, they seem to like my kitchen best. I'm the cook of the house.
And she's a pretty good cook.
Oh, yeah, God. I like cooking, so it's really about
a good cook.
I mean, the word women's lip props.
Well, I don't think there's anything wrong with cooking, is there? It doesn't like
I believe in men's lip. It's about time, men.
Yeah.
Men's lib, men of the world, rise up, unite!
Come on, men! Who are these women? Come on, men! Let's do it! It's us! Look at them!
That's fine with me, let the men cook, it's alright, yes.
Excuse me, won't you? I'm sorry for that outburst.
That's it, women, let the men cook, let the men clean, men's lib.
Yeah, right.
Percussion
player. Wonderful. Wonderful Copenhagen.
Hey, Copenhagen. 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 Tak. Danske. Bacon.
And then Sea Moon, we also did when we did Hi Hi Hi, because they banned Hi Hi Hi, so Sea Moon got to the airplay. It was very popular.
You've heard of her. Nina Sea Moon.
There once was a man named Dave, who lived in a... No, we can't.
Awesome. Look, but when you do, for instance, a film like the one that you did from Venus and Mars, the rock show, I mean, that was from a concert.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, well, we all know what problems we have doing live things from a concert.
Yeah.
How did you do that one?
How do you do what you do to me?
Yeah, that was in Australia.
We didn't even know it was going on, I don't think.
He didn't know it was going on.
I didn't know.
We knew it was going on. But he's all right. This is Bilbo, our percussion player. He's very good. Good lad. A few drinks, he's fine. Lovely.
Nigeria. Jamaica. Yeah.
One, man.
What was the other one?
I don't like candles.
Okay, but the song in itself seems to be half a declaration of love and half putting down rock music.
Oh, yeah.
Well, oh, yeah.
It's time somebody put it down, mate.
Was that too deep?
That was a bit too deep, Edmund, yeah.
Oh.
You've met Edmund, have you?
Well, I'm here.
But he's over the side.
Now, rock and roll's here to stay. It will never die.
No, we like rock and roll. Definitely.
I can't stand it myself.
He's more ballad. He's more ballad.
Do you want to get in your ear, please?
There goes some.
Engelbert Humperdinck. It's my style, mate. Please release me.
Okay, can I finish? Can I finish by asking you the question that annoys everybody of you? What about
yes,
the Beatles?
Yes, let's get annoyed.
No, it doesn't annoy.
What about the Beatles?
You don't say that.
How do you spell
it? Double E.
Volkswagen, you mean?
No.
How's it going, Paul? All right.
What was the question again? I forgot the question.
Well, how you felt about a certain rock group that was known in the late 60s but began in the roaring rock days in
the
late
roaring
50s.
20s.
How I feel about them?
Yeah. Great group.
Love them.
Great group.
Would you like to do that stuff again?
Well, you know, I mean, when a group's broken up, it's broken up, you know, so it's difficult to do it again, but it was very good. I enjoyed it.
And Laura, you go?
Well, how do the other people feel about that?
Well, they wouldn't mind, I don't think. No,
I wouldn't mind.
He wouldn't let me do it. Bilbo wouldn't let me do it. The rest of them, fine.
Completely out of the question.
Bilbo's our hitman.
This is on.
Any broken legs?
Bilbo.
Niggers on your head.
Niggers or knickers?
Niggers.
Bilbo.
Where's it? Bilbo Baggins.